So check out the amount of the silver albino arowanas in this pond. And next up, take a look at the emperor snakehead, like one of the largest snakehead out there. And I've never actually seen this before, a red marble gar. And as well as this so interesting platinum red-tailed catfish. So recently I made a trip down to Qian Hu Fish Farm. So Qian Hu Fish Farm is like one of the largest freshwater wholesaler in Singapore. So they do a lot of different types of freshwater, which I'm going to show you today. We start up with the entrance area here. They have like the koi section. This is like a lot of different types of koi, goldfish. It spans out quite a lot though. If you see from here, right, this is like a whole area filled with just different types of koi, different sizes, all the way down to goldfish and stuff. We move to the other side, right? They have this really interesting emperor snakehead. I have no idea why is it red. Freshwater guys out there, help me out. I don't know, is it a moth or something like that? But the one that I'm very familiar with, right, is the normal emperor, which looks like this. This is how a normal emperor snakehead would look like. The emperors by far grow the largest among the snakehead family, and they are invasive species, but they are very, very fun monster fish to keep. They also recently have this like concept tank, really nice string tanks. I like the aluminum frame and the crystal glass tanks on them to display the little streams. Very unique, very interesting thing. We walk into this section here. There's like mainly a lot of different small schooling fishes. Your tetras, your rasboras. Yeah, we do see a lot of all these smaller schooling fishes. As we head down, we actually went into the House of Dragon. But however, when I visited them that day, right, there isn't really much going on in the House of Dragon. So I decided not to film anything in here. We head out again, and then we head out to this area here where they put a lot of these huge iOS tanks out there that house really a lot of different types of very interesting species. The first tank that really catches my eye, right, this is like one of my favorite fish, which is the spider calberry peacock bass. One of my favorite. I was so tempted to pick one up that day, but however, because I was running to a lot of different other places, right, I don't really want to hold the fish everywhere I go, and I really got two at home. So to me, like, should I get one, should I not get one? But I've always liked the calberry spider because of the very nice the gold speckles on them is just insanely beautiful, especially when they get to like full grown adult size. They have this golden discus, pretty nice. I took them because I find that they are very, the colors are really good. But next fish that I want to show you, right, is this over here, the red marble gar. I've never seen a red marble gar before. This is the first time I've seen one, and at a price tag of $2,988, I have really no idea what's so special about this gar. So freshwater guys, please do enlighten me. Why is this guy cost $3,000? I've always been a platinum gar person. This is interesting. I like the colors of it, and it's really interactive though. The whole time I was out there with my camera, right, he came up to me and like calling to me, that kind of reaction. They also have the typical the silver arowanas, and I've never really been a fan of them. I'm always more into the albinos, which I believe Qian Hu is really good with their albinos, silver arowanas. The color of it though is so freaking gold. I have no idea why is it so gold, but they look so stunning over there. Every albino silver arowana that I've seen in Qian Hu, right, is just, it looks like a gold bar swimming in the water, which is just damn interesting. The parrotfish, never really a fan of them. Don't get me wrong, I'm just not a fan of the parrotfishes. We move in. This is an area where they house quite a lot of flower horns though. People who like flower horns, right, this is like one place that they have caught different flower horns. But one fish caught my attention again, and this is one fish I really, really, really want, which is this over here, the platinum red-tailed catfish. At $980 though, however, the colors of it, that's stunning. It's It's not really white, it's very goldenish kind of thing with the little red hue in them. It's stunning. This is one fish that I really like a lot. Yeah, we move back to the flower horns, right? I'm not really a fan of flower horns. I find that they are very maybe it's just a Singapore kind of concept. They're more of the uncle fishes, but the flower horns there are really good, really active, and they respond very, very well. Very healthy specimen. If you want to look for flower horns, very good affordable pricing, go to them. I would say that look at how aggressive these guys are. They follow finger, they follow the camera, which is really good sign for healthy fishes that you guys can check. Prices wise, pretty affordable. If you really want a flower horn, I'll recommend Qian Hu, one of the places to get. We move down the rows, there's a lot of different types of cichlids. I've never really been a fan of cichlids though. They are like the schooling fishes of the freshwater world. A lot of different types, different varieties of cichlids. Not really a big fan of them, but however, there's one of those cichlids that did catch my attention. If I'm not wrong, it's the blue Jack Dempsey's. I believe I have a video of it right now. I believe it's these guys. These guys are the blue Jack Dempsey's, or it could be something else that I've seen. But yeah, I always like them because of the electric blue coloration. But however, I don't really have a specific tank for them at home, so I decided to give it a skip as well. The main purpose that I came here was actually to look at arowanas, but however, I didn't really see any arowanas. They have a whole section of goldfish, which I'm not going to film them because I'm not really a big fan of goldfish. If you want to see goldfish, leave a comment down below. I will head back there soon. The only arowana that I've seen there, which is also, this is iconic for Qian Hu, which is their Violet Fusion Super Red. Way too far out my price point. You guys have seen my previous video to BCA. I'm actually looking for an Asian arowana. But however, 1,100, still not something that I'm willing to spend right now. If Qian Hu, you are watching this and you want to sponsor me one, feel free, you have my contact, so please do so. Next thing that I'll look at is, I was actually contemplating between to get an Asian arowana or a black diamond stingray. Still looking for a pair as well. They are not that costly compared to many years ago. Don't get me wrong, they are not say because they are cheaper now, it's just that there's a lot of different qualities out there. If you want to get black diamonds, right, there's those really good quality ones that still go up to a couple of thousand each. But if you just want something for fun like me, I believe these are very good signs for them. They have pearls as well. Not really a big fan of pearls. I'm more to the black diamond guy, so I would probably not get a pearl. But pricing wise, about $4 a pair, I think they are pretty affordable. The next thing that really catches my eye, right, as the turtles. You guys seen my earlier video on my turtles, right? Qian Hu actually do have like a full area where they house all the different types of turtles. They have the caramel turtles, one of my favorites, but same thing, it's still too damn costly. It's like $1,000 for, it's $1,008 for a turtle. They have the charcoal, which is about $1,002. I would say these are like really for die-hard turtle fans. If you guys want to keep turtles, right, these are the turtles to go for. I believe I've come to the end of this week's video. Big thanks to Qian Hu for letting us film this area here. So many things to do, so many things to look at. For those of you guys out here who wants a family outing day, right, I highly do recommend this place for you guys. There's like a cafe there. There is kampong fishing. There's so many different fish to see, especially for all the freshwater hobbies out there. Aside from that, I've gone back to this video because it's one fish that I really cannot live without. It's the platinum red-tailed catfish. This is the first time I'm actually seeing the platinum catfish though, so I do actually do fall in love with it so much. But however, the price tag of $1,000, I have really no idea if I should spend that money or not. Leave a comment down below whether should I get this beauty or not. And if Qian Hu, you are watching this, right, if you want to sponsor one of these guys to me, you have my contact, please do look for me down below. I would really love to have one of these guys. Same thing, if you guys like all the videos that I've put up for you guys, there's a lot of more LFS tour coming up. Like, share it out, and I will see you guys soon next week.